Squeaks has been asking when we're going to make slime for a really long time now, and so have our viewers. Well, guess what, Squeaks? Today is the day. It's going to be squishy and smooth and probably pretty slimy. And you can make it with a few simple ingredients that you probably already have at home. First, you'll need a bowl, a measuring spoon, a stick or plastic spoon for mixing, a container if you want to store your slime when you're done, and a grown-up to help. Our slime is going to be made out of regular school glue, baking soda, food coloring, and contact solution. The contact solution should have something called boric acid in it, which a lot of them do. You can ask a grown-up to help you make sure. All the ingredients we're using are safe to touch. That's the whole point of slime, but it's not for eating. Now for the fun part. Let's start making slime. First, pour the whole bottle of glue into the bowl, and I bet you can guess what it's used for. You're right, to make it sticky, but maybe not in the way you're expecting. Glue is sticky, but it's still very liquidy. To make slime, we need to make the glue stick to itself, so it becomes a big ball of goop we can pull apart and squeeze together. And that's what the other ingredients are for. Well, except the food coloring. That's just to make the slime a cool color. So the next thing we're going to do is add 1 tablespoon of baking soda to the glue. We'll mix the baking soda and the glue together until it's completely dissolved. Then we'll add a few drops of food coloring and mix it together. Keep adding food coloring until you make the color you want. We're using fuchsia. I know this is the right color, but does this look like finished slime to you, Squeaks? Nah, it still looks too liquidy. What do you think will happen when we add the contact solution? Let's see. I'm going to start adding the contact solution 1 teaspoon at a time so we can really observe what's happening. Oh, wow! It's really starting to get more goopy. Woo! I'm gonna add another teaspoon and keep stirring. It looks like the slime is getting even thicker and stickier now. It's even sticking to itself. That's because of the way the baking soda and contact solution we added are changing the glue. The little tiny pieces or molecules that make up glue are too small for us to see. But if you could, you'd see that they're a lot like tiny chains. At first, the glue was very runny because the chains were all sliding around each other. But the baking soda and contact solution made the chains all tangled up. That's why the mixture sticks to itself and becomes more like a ball of slime. Once the slime is sticking to itself more than the bowl, you'll know it's almost ready. If your slime is still runny, keep slowly adding a little more contact solution to the glue and baking soda mixture. Finally, to get your slime to the perfect level of sliminess, you'll have to knead it with your hands, either in the bowl or on a surface that's easy to clean. Keep kneading and stretching and even squishing it together until it's the perfect slime consistency. This slime is so cool. I can form it into a ball. It's almost solid, but I can also pull it apart and let it drip down. It's almost like the slime is a solid and a liquid at the same time, and that's what makes slime so special. Most types of liquid only turn solid when they freeze, like when water freezes into ice, and most types of solids only turn liquid when they melt, but slime is different. When you just leave it alone, it spreads out in the bowl like a liquid. Even though the little chains in the slime are connected to each other, they can still slide around each other enough to flow like a liquid. But when you press it together or pull it apart, the chains get more tangled and the slime becomes much more like a solid. Just like the oobleck we made that one time, remember, Squeaks? Yeah, keep playing around with your slime to see what else you can discover about it. When you're done playing, you can put it away in a container so it doesn't dry out. And just make sure to wash your hands when you're done. But most important of all, have fun. Did you make this slime? What did you learn about it? Ask a grown-up to help you leave a comment down below or send us an email to kids@scishow.com, and we'll see you next time here at the fort.